coming up next on Your Green Life.
Well, I think you must eat a lot of candy.
I do have a bad habit.
Got a sweet tooth? So does this artist. But you won't find her wrappers in the trash.
California grape growing has been taking advantage of California sunshine for a long time.
Plus, solar panels that float. And it's happening in California wine country.
Yes, Max.
You rock.
You rock? Who rocks? Safira?
Okay.
And it's a race to save the leatherback, with these students cheering them on.
If I'm a dog walker, what can I do to make sure that I don't erode things that were here before me?
Plus, a greener walk in the park with man's best friend. It's all next on Your Green Life.
Hey everybody, thanks for watching Your Green Life.
We're here at Coyote Point Museum for Environmental Education.
Yep, this place has a ton of exhibits that kids can get really close to, including some with endangered animals.
Speaking of which, the race is on to save one of the great endangered turtles, and we caught up with some students cheering them on.
Jess Lura's got a class full of kids crazy about turtles, or at least one turtle in particular.
Yes, Max.
You rock.
You rock? Who rocks? Safira?
Okay.
Lura's class at the Bullis School in Los Altos is cheering on an international race. The competitors are one of the ocean's most endangered species.
Everyone has a turtle. They like sponsor a turtle. And it's basically a migration race. So they lay their eggs and then, well, now we're racing to the international dateline.
Now, turtle racing might sound about as exciting as watching paint dry, but not if it's the Great Turtle Race.
The Great Turtle Race follows 11 satellite-tracked leatherback turtles racing towards the international dateline from their feeding areas off our California coast and their nesting beaches in Indonesia.
It gives the students sort of a face to associate with endangered species. It gives them something to sort of focus on. It's hard because the first graders, they have a hard time with the abstract. And so this is a very concrete thing for them to focus on.
GPS backpacks are strapped to the turtles, and that allows the class to follow along online, in class, or at home.
I just log on and then I see how Sophia is doing, and I see how the rest of the turtles are doing, and see what place everyone's in. And I also look at like the information, like there are little like cards almost things that you can see the information about all the turtles.
It's a mix of new media, inspired teaching, and imagination.
I think you're right. I don't think they know they're racing.
But it's not just fun and games. Behind the race are some serious issues.
Unfortunately, the population of leatherbacks is hurting. Scientists have estimated that about 95% of the population has been lost in the last 20 to 25 years. Now that's a pretty dramatic decline.
So what are the biggest threats to this animal that's been around since the time of the dinosaurs? Humans. Turtle eggs are a delicacy and nesting beaches are being overdeveloped. Longline fishing is another problem for the world's largest reptile.
There are a lot of endangered species out there. We want to help all of them, but we're going one step at a time by helping the turtles. We can't really help the polar bears right now. We can try and arrange a trip to the Arctic, but I don't think so.
Of course, it sure doesn't hurt when your turtle is winning either.
Your odd students in different grades come up to me and be like, Miss Laura, Safira's, you know, they're so excited that she's in first place. Our Safira last year did okay. She for a while was in third, but she ended up finishing in eighth, and it was exciting, but they're really excited this year to be doing so well.